Well, there are crises around the world, and there are people around the world that are completely forgotten, that are off the mattering map, if you will. And what Not Our Watch represents is a group of guys who have tremendous appeal to publics around the world.
Brad Pitt, Matt Damon, George Clooney,
and Don Cheadle. Yeah. And the spotlight's on these guys. And all they're doing is holding up a mirror and redirecting that light to some of these forgotten places in a way that all of us that have toiled for decades in trying to work and raise some visibility on this could never do. So they're the ultimate allies for human rights activists, for those working to support peace and support development all over the world, to shine a greater spotlight on these issues and demand that attention be paid and action be taken.
We also argued, you know, a lot of it was that rather than trying to pick up the pieces after a genocide, pick up the body bags afterwards, what can we do to prevent it before it happens? Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, it's like any great medical problem. It's much better, you know, to do it before you have to triage it later. And so our goal was to say, well, let's find the hot spots they're hitting and let's do what we can to try to bring attention, so much attention to it that it makes it harder for those things to explode now. As opposed to trying to mop up the mess later, which is always much worse.
You were raised in too hard like that, weren't you?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
In Kentucky. Your father and your mother?
Both my parents, yeah. My parents were... But, you know, I'm 54 years old. I was raised in the 60s and 70s. And that was when, you know, if there was ever a time to be an activist, you know, it was the civil rights movement, and the women's rights movement, and the Vietnam movement, and the drug counterculture, and I mean, you go down the list. There were millions of reasons to get up and speak. So literally everyone I knew from the time they were 5 or 6 years old, mm-hmm. you were wearing armbands, and you know, it was just part of who you were. And my parents were very much involved in all that. You know, we were around for all the assassinations.
How did you see that as a child, that they were involved into society?
Well, you know,
example of it.
Well, it's not as fun when you're a kid, right? Because your parents are trying to make you do very noble things.
Like what?
Well, like, you know, Christmas, where you'd have to. So my father was on a television show, and he would write in and say, "You know, people would write in and say, well, you know, we're not going to have Christmas. My husband lost his job, and so my dad would say, okay, this Christmas, you're going to make money mowing lawns, and my sister's going to make money babysitting, and we're all going to work all, you know, fall long. And Christmas morning, we're going to go to this stranger's house, and we're going to make them dinner, and we're going to give them presents that we've never met before we could celebrate Christmas. And I hated it. Yeah. You know, come on, you want to go have Christmas. But my parents always believed that it was much more important to celebrate that you can't really celebrate anything unless everybody can celebrate in some one way or another.